Hello guys, Dan here, welcome back to the channel. In today's video I'm going to finish my Beyond Operation Karlstrom, and this time I'm going to paint Jinko for the Yuching. I'm going to paint it using mostly, like 90% of the paint job will be done with the contrast paints. So I will show you how to skip like most of the traditional painting using the contrast, and this will cut a lot of time during your paint job, and you'll be able to finish model to look like this in maybe like 1 or 2 hours max. So without further ado, let's start. Whenever we need to work with contrast, I prime my model with the red bone spray. If you don't have any spray like that, you can use any bone color, very bright bone color, and it will achieve the same effect. And then I will start applying contrast paints. This will be applied like straight from the pot, and all these spots are well shaken before I started. And then I will just start applying colors one by one and blocking the parts of the model to the specific color. I will start with the Apothecary White, and I will use this one only for his jacket. Then I'm going to move to a Griphout Orange, and I'm going to apply this paint on his armor. And the other thing that I need to tell you is whenever you are working with the contrast paint, use some of your old brushes, because I'm using these paints now since they have been released, and they destroyed already 2 or 3 of my brushes. I don't know what is inside, but it looks like it damages the brushes over the time. So I have like one specific brush that I use only for the contrast paints. For his leather pouches, I'm going to use Granta Fur Contrast, and I will apply it like in one very thick coat. Like every time I'm applying these contrast paints, it will going to be a one very thick coat, unless I say that I applied it in some different way. For his furry part of the cloak, I'm going to use Agaros Dunes. Guys, when I'm painting this, I have all my contrast paints pots open in front of me, so I'm usually like going back and forth, and I'm trying to fill up all the gaps so you cannot actually see any primer under it, because the primer is very bright, so it is possible that you will see some white dots. So whenever it's possible, just don't be afraid to go back to the previous color and fill up all the gaps. Now I will use the Black Templar, and I'm going to paint all the black parts. Only on the weapon I will go with the 2 very thick coats. On everything else I will go only on 1. And the other thing that you need to pay attention with when working with the contrast is to start with the brightest color and then start working towards the darkest one. And you need to be very careful not to overlap over each other, because it will create stains and it will look ugly. So just you can paint a little slower and try to be more precise. For the pants, I use the Teradon Turquoise. And since this is one of the last contrast paints that I paint between all the others, I was like really precise. For this little shaft that he's standing on, I'm going to use Basilicanum Grey, and I'm just going to apply like a heavy layer of it just on the base. This will be mostly covered with artificial snow, so you don't really need to pay that much attention to it. So this is how does it look after applying contrast paints. Now you need to leave it for everything to dry and settle down. So it took in my case around like 45 minutes. So it actually, I spent more time waiting for this model to dry than actually applying the contrast paint, which is actually really good. If you're really in the hurry and you don't want to paint anymore, you can stop here and you can use the model in this state. But from this point, I'm going to highlight it and I'm going to make it to look a lot better. So I will start now highlighting the surfaces. I will start with his armor first, and I will use the Scrofulous Brown. And I'm going to repaint mostly like everything that was orange before, but not going inside the recesses. So I will focus on all the areas that are not inside the recesses because I want to keep my shadows intact. Now I'm going to mix some dead white with the Scrofulous Brown, and I'm going to start highlighting the model. I will do like the edge highlight, but I will draw a very thick lines. It will going to be highlighted, but it's not going to be a final highlight. It will be one more little highlight on top of this. So just focus on the edges and on the areas that are elevated and mostly exposed to the light. Now I'm going to use pure white, and in this case I'm using a different white than it's actually a dead white, because dead white was airbrush color and it was very liquidy. It's very watery, so it was very easy to mix it, but this one is little thicker and it's much better to apply highlights with it. So what I'm going to do is to apply a final edge highlight to all the edge areas of the armor, and this is going to be a very thin highlight, so I'm going to draw a very thin lines. What I'm going to do to highlight with this color is everything else. So I will highlight all these furry parts of his coat, I will highlight his coat, and I will highlight his weapon. So more or less you're going around the whole model, everything actually except his pouch and his pants. This is going to be done as an edge highlight, so you're going to go around making like an angle of 45 degrees to 90 degrees with your brush against the surface of the gun or any other surface, and you're going to draw a very thin lines. So don't be afraid like just to take the paint, draw one line, take more paint, draw another line, draw little dots here and there, just go around, because this is your final highlight and this will actually make everything looking great together. For his coat, you actually don't need to do that much. You just need to highlight just the folds and the most raised areas of the coat. So only a few lines and everything will look good together. For his leather pouch, I used the sunny skin tone. You can apply this in two different ways, as an edge highlight or as a stippling technique on the edges. Depend on you and how you want this to look like, you can do these two different approaches. I did it as a little edge highlight and it looked great, so I was happy, so I just proceed doing the next step. For the pants, I'm going to use the turquoise. And the first thing that I'm going to do is to repaint the pants with this color. Only thing is I'm going to leave all the recesses intact, so that will act as my shadows, so I don't need to do any more work there. And then I'm going to add a little of white to this paint, that will create my highlight. And this will be my one and only highlight on this, and it's going to be applied only on the most raised areas of the folds. And the last thing that I'm going to do is to paint all the LEDs on this model. So I will use Ascorpena Green and I will just fill out these little holes with this color. You can put one dot of white at the end just to create a little highlight, but it is not necessary. You can leave it this way and it will look great. So guys, I'm going to wrap up this video here. If you're interested how I did the base for this model, I will include the link to that video in the comment section down below. And I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel. It will help this channel grow and it will mean a lot to me. And if you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them in the section down below. I will give my best to reply. This will be all for now. Stay safe, take care, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.